Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm back with another video. So I did these braids using Toyoka Lawn Fiber Hair. So if you guys don't know, I am a brand ambassador for Toyoka Lawn Fiber Hair. They sent me 9 packs of hair and I only used 6 packs of hair. And I also have like highlight color. I only use like a few strands, maybe 3-4 strands of this color number 27. So the hair that I used is called Soft Dread 100% Toyoka Lawn, and it is also flame retardant, and it is by Sensational. They're African collection. So this is the kind of hair I used. So this is color number 30, but I didn't get to use this color because I wanted my main color to be black. So it's one of the packets that I didn't use. So I really love this hair, you guys. This hair is so soft. I was super surprised because I don't like anything heavy on my head. When it's time to sleep, I struggle when the hair is too heavy. The curl pattern is so amazing. And I'm actually feeling this hair, you guys. So if you guys are interested in seeing how I achieved this look using Toyoka Lawn Fiber Hair, please do continue watching. So the first thing that you want to do, guys, is to make sure that you are starting on fresh, clean hair. And then the next thing is you need to do some cornrows. So some of these cornrows were joined together, but all the cornrows were going all the way to the back. So the hair that I used is 100% Toyoka Lawn, and the name of the hair that I use is by Sensational, and it's Soft Dread. One thing that I love about this hair is that it comes separated already, so you don't really have to separate this hair. It's already separated for you, so all you just need is a crochet hook and that's it. So I love this, and the hair doesn't tangle. I did not separate the hair at all, and I did not cut it as well. So I started braiding my hair at the back, just doing the usual looping it 3 times and that's it. So the next color that I used was color number 27. I just wanted to highlight my hair. I kept on doing my hair looping it 3 times, like as you can see right here. So this is just going to make sure that your crochet braids are secure and look neater as well. The next thing that I'm gonna show you guys is how to do the invisible part or knotless crochet braids. You can actually tell the difference here between the invisible parting and the other side where I was actually knotting the hair. This all depends on an individual, whether you like invisible knotless parting or you actually want the knots to be showing. So this really depends on an individual. I'm just going to demonstrate to you how you can do the invisible parting or the knotless parting. So instead of you looping in the 2 ends of the braid, you don't have to loop in the 2 ends of the braid. What you're trying to achieve is the invisible knotless parting, so that people won't be able to see the knots. You loop only one side of the braid and you loop it twice, and then you tie it just to secure it. And that is so simple, you guys. Very, very easy. These crochet braids are very versatile, you guys. If you feel like you don't want a side part, you can always do a middle part, you can always do like a band. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video, and please let me know how you would like to see me styling this hair. Any suggestions are welcome in the comment section down below. Thank you guys. So you can find Toyoka Lawn Fiber on their website, and you can also find them on Facebook. They're also on Instagram, so you can just Google Toyoka Lawn, you'll be able to find them. So I hope you guys did find this video helpful, and please don't forget to thumbs up this video. Also comment, rate, share and subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye for now.